Now, on the name and data plate of our transformer, we get the information that we need to know about that transformer to make the proper connection. Now, I'm going to put a typical transformer rating that you might find on one of your transformers, and I'm just picking a typical transformer that could be maybe on our, particularly our rural system. We've got 12470 ground Y slant 7200 dash 120240. Okay. Now, this is a transformer which, if you're familiar with it, you know that there is a single bushing. And that's probably the first thing that would jump out at you in this rating, is that that is a single bushing transformer. Now, I want to show you how you go about reading this transformer rating that would be on the name and data plate of that particular transformer. Now, these numbers here you want to understand are system voltages. And that when you read those, you will understand that if I have a 12470 system all connected Y, and that I'll have a coil voltage of 7200 on that transformer. Now, we're going to come back to those ratings in just a little bit. Before we do that, I want to give you the meaning of the symbols that are in that transformer rating. Now, you see there's a slant here, there's a hyphen here, there's a slant there. The slant designates same winding. The hyphen designates separate winding. In other words, this would be the high side of that transformer. This would be the low side of that transformer. The meaning of that rating we'll go through in just a little bit. There's one other that isn't in there, and I'll give you an example of that. If I had a transformer that was rated 2400 slant 4160 Y X 7200 slant 12470 Y dash 120240. Now that's a long handle there. My reason for putting this one down is that it's got X between it. You'll see there's a rating above it, below it, all on the high side of that transformer. Remember that hyphen denotes the different, the separation between your high and low side. This particular transformer is a dual rated transformer or multiple. This X in between denotes that it is a multiple wound transformer, which means it could be connected on high or low depending on which rating you want. So now those are the three symbols that we want to know in particular. We've got a slant, same winding, hyphen, separate winding, and an X over here which denotes separate winding. Okay? Now, what we want to do is get into some of the common ratings. Okay, and what they mean to us. You know, when I first started teaching transformers, I got the idea that it'd probably be easier if they would just give you the coil voltage and then let you determine how you would have to connect it onto your system to get the coil voltage that you want. However, there's much more information in that rating than just that. In other words, you know whether it's good for a wire or delta connection, you know whether it has there's dual wound, you know what the coil voltage is. There's a lot of information that is supplied to you, both on the high and the low side of that transformer. Now, on transformer ratings, you've got it in your book, and you may want to turn to that page to follow along. It's in the 2-8, section 2-8, and follow along with me, and then I'll explain it as we go. Now, the first one I want to cover is transformers that have ratings like this. Now, I'm going to just show high side ratings. We'll get into low side later. 12,470 ground Y slant 7200 dash 13,200 ground Y slant 7620 hyphen and so on. Anyway, you get the idea there. There's several of them that could be rated like this. Very seldom you see this one. Most times the utilities use a transformer rated that size, and they would rather have a transformer that had two bushings. In other words, good for Y or Delta. Now let me tell you what this means. The way I read this, those are system voltages. And it's telling me that if I have a 4160 system, I don't even have to know whether it's three or four wire. It's going to be four wire, but I don't even have to know that. It's telling me that I would connect it Y. If I had a 12,470 system, I would connect it Y. 13,200 system, I would connect it Y. Either case, those would be the coil voltages of what I would have on those transformers at 100% rating. Now, this transformer has a single bushing on the high side. If I would show you the high side, it would look like this. And the other side is grounded to the tank on the inside. In other words, it has an H1 bushing. It looks like that. Okay, it has an H1 bushing, and that transformer is grounded on the H2 to the tank on the inside. In other words, when you ground that transformer out, you're making the complete connection on the high side. This transformer is good for a Y connection only. Now, if I connect Y on that system, take this system, divide it by 1.73, you would see that I would have 2400 volt in for a coil voltage. Okay? Now, one of the if you know that you're going to use those transformers single phase and so on, and it's Y on your particular system, then why buy that added bushing, added cost? There's another savings as well. As the windings get closer and closer down to ground potential, they can use less and less insulation value. It's a particular transformer, you see, and most transformers are connected single phase on most rural systems. So they would use a transformer such as this. Okay, this was one way of rating the high side system. Now let's get another one here. Now the next one that I want to give you is written like this. 12,000 dash. It might have 480 dash. It might have 13,200 dash. We've got all kinds. We could have 34,400 dash. Okay, now when it's written like that, that means that transformer now is good for a Delta connection only, which means high voltage, low current, which means the conductor size is probably smaller and that sort of thing. Anyway, this transformer is good for a Delta only. Now, when we say Y or Delta, you want to get used to the idea of thinking in terms like this, that when I make a Y connection, it's going to be phase to ground. When I make a Delta connection, it's going to be phase to phase. Okay? Now, with these transformers, you see, I would be connecting Delta on a 12,000 volt system. I would be connecting, say for example, like some of your dry type transformers. Or maybe the electrician installs them for you inside the building. Or it installs it for the consumer, I should say. If I had a 480 volt service feeding a particular consumer, I could connect this thing up. Here I could connect up to that system and say on the high side have 480 and then go to 240, 120 volt if it was a dry type transformer. Here again, these are good for Delta only. Now if I would draw those out, it would look like this. I would have two bushings. I would have an H1 and an H2. Good for Delta connection only. Now, there's another one that we want to pay particular attention to, and that's the transformers written like this. 2400 slant 4160 Y dash. 7200 slant 12470 Y dash. I could have 7620 slant 13200 Y dash. Now those transformers there are good for a Y or a delta connection. It'll have two bushings in the high side, H1 and H2. And the way you would read this, now remember those are system voltages in there. The way you would read this is that if I had a 2400 volt system, now they don't put it in there, but it's understood to be there, that I would connect that transformer delta. If I had a 4160 system, I would connect Y. You see, in either case, what I'm going to put on that transformer is a voltage of 2400 volt. Same way down here, if I had a 7200 volt system, I would connect that transformer delta. If I had a 12470 system, I would connect it Y. So you see the importance of system voltage. You have to understand what we mean when we say system voltages. If you know your system, you know your system voltage, you know your transformer rating, then you know how you make your high side connection. We'll get into the low side after a bit. Okay?